Mr. Oval claims he's not responsible because he got scammed too.
This is a matter of Devon Stevens versus Tony Oval, and Mr. Stevens, you're suing your cousin, I understand, for $1,582. You blame him for having to pay an additional cost of some concert tickets for you and your daughter.
Correct.
And on a trip to New York. Is that right?
That's right.
All right, let me hear from you.
Okay. Well, the reason why I'm suing him for $1,582 is because he didn't hold up his end of the bargain. So basically, he was supposed to take care of the tickets to the Princess G concert.
And how many tickets was he supposed to purchase?
He's supposed to get all four tickets.
Okay, four tickets, and you were paying hotel for?
I was paying hotel for everybody, all four of us.
All right, and what about airfare?
I was paying to fly myself and my daughter.
What was Mr. Oboe?
He was coming from New Jersey.
And how old is his daughter?
They're both six. Okay. Both of our daughters actually the same age.
Okay, so now tell me what happened.
We get there, and, you know, we had the tickets, but then when we got to the gate, they were bogus tickets. There was no barcode on them. So they couldn't scan the tickets. So I'm sitting here looking stupid, like, okay, what's going on? My daughter giving me the look like, my daddy, I want to get in this concert. What are we going to do? So I'm looking at him. He's sitting here looking silly, like, ooh, you know.
Well, so what happened with the tickets?
I bought the tickets online. A friend of mine at the office told me that there was a website where I could get these tickets. I thought it was part of Princess G's management that was selling the tickets. It was my first time buying concert tickets, and I'm kind of new to this this whole thing.
Okay, so how much did you pay for those tickets?
I paid a total of $1,400. That's for four tickets. We had flow seats. That's like $7.
So, okay, so when the tickets were bogus, what did you do?
I asked the lady at the front, how can I get new tickets? She directed me to a website on my phone. You know, I went on there, purchased the tickets, $791. Double that, because I got tickets for myself and my daughter.
That's how we get to the 1582.
Exactly. That's why he owes me money.
Coming up.
Why does he owe you?
Because he gave me bogus tickets in the first place.
I didn't know they were bogus. We only found out at the venue. And when I tried to solve it with him, that's when he was kind of making me look like an irresponsible father.
Who is suing Tony Oboe for $1,582.
So why does he owe you?
Because he gave me bogus tickets in the first place. So I think he should have been more responsible in research before he did that.
I didn't know they were bogus. We only found out at the venue. We stood in line for quite a while to get to the scanning booth.
So
we discovered right there that the tickets were fake. And when I tried to solve it with him, that's when he was kind of making me look like an irresponsible father. Because if we bought bogus tickets from a website and you're being preferred for another website, why would I pay for another $800 a ticket to go see Pope Princess?
If you accept the responsibility to purchase the tickets and you're splitting the responsibility, just like I'm going on a trip with a group of friends of mine, I accept the responsibility to buy all the tickets for this concert in advance, for this festival. Now, what do you think?
I didn't know there was no way of telling. So now I know. Now I know that people do kind of scams like that online.
When you accept the responsibility for splitting the cost of an event or whatever, for doing something, and you don't live up to your end of the bargain.
Yes, Your Honor, I agree, but I did not tell him to go purchase the other tickets. He's suing me for the extra tickets that he purchased.
Right.
You should have just told your own daughter that disappointment is happening.
You're like her advice now.
Yes.
Judge Maybelline's verdict, when Justice with Judge Maybelline returns.
A Pope Princess. We rarely get to see each other. It was time for the girls to bond. They're growing up so fast. But he just didn't want to do that. And he just didn't want to listen to my advice. Why would he be taken again from a website? Because there were so many other things we would have done, and our girls would have appreciated that.
When he left you, you had a choice of what you would do with your daughter.
Exactly.
He made a choice that I am going to get these tickets for my daughter and us to go to this concert because to him it was very important. But now $1,400 is out of his pocket. So your tickets would have cost you $700. And you didn't have to pay anything according to the agreement, right?
Right.
So you're entitled to $700.
I should get more than that. I spent $1,582.
I know.
When I wasn't told to be spending
that. But now that there is a mistake made, you're only entitled to what you lost. He was responsible for $700, not $1,582. At that point, you make a decision. You made the decision to pay that $1,582. I'm going to order him to pay you back $700. My judgment for the plaintiff. Defendant pay the plaintiff $700. Court is adjourned.
All rise.
Judge. Judge Maybelline has ruled in favor of the plaintiff. The defendant is ordered to pay $700.
I'm glad we came to court today. Even though I didn't get all my money back, you still owe me an apology.
I can't believe family took me to court over bogus tickets. You need to listen to the judge.